Right, so in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to buy tracks for us to process Bridge Church. So usually I buy all the tracks from multitracks.com. They usually, as soon as an album's released, they'll release it together at the same time because they get it straight from the artist, which is awesome. So it's a master recording of it. If I can't find it in multitracks, I'll look at the other one. It's called Loop Community, which is always my second preference. I'll let you know why a little bit later. And if we're looking at circular songs, I'll go into this website called karaokeversion.com. Just wait until it loads. Anyway, so if we're buying it from multitracks.com, so this is what we do. So let's just take, for example, where we want to get the song Let There Be Light from Hillsong. So I'll just search. And look for it at the bottom. There we go. Click on that one. And this, it brings you to this page. So Multitracks has got a couple options that you can buy from, which is Multitracks. So you get it all in individual stems. This is just a preview to show you what's available in there. Or if you don't have time to do it, it's a custom mix. And this is what we used to do. It's cheaper, but it's not flexible. So once you mix all the stems that you want here in terms of volume, what you want and what you don't want to be included in the track, you export it, you buy it, and that's it. You can't do anything else, so you're locked in. So the best bit is always to get it from Multitracks, just the Multitracks, which is the original master stem bundle. There are two options. You can get it in Wave or M4A, which is like an Apple format. It's a bit cheaper. It's $35 or 35 credit for M4A and 39 for Wave. I usually just buy M4A because you won't really hear the difference. And you can select what key you want. We'll just leave it as the original. And when you want, you know, you can change it a little bit later. So for example, let's just say I want to get M4A, which I'll click on this download button, but because I've already bought it, that's fine. I'll just put Wave in the basket in the view card, and then you click checkout. I usually buy credits in advance just so that it's a bit cheaper, and that way you don't have to use your credit card to buy it, but I'll sort of load it up from time to time. And when you want to get that, just click checkout and all that kind of thing, because I've already got that song in my account. I'm just going to go to my account, and there it is. Let There Be Light. So click Multitrack M4A. When you click that one, it's going to bring you into a dialog box, and you can choose the keys that you want to get it in. What I usually do is I'll just buy the original key, which is the mid, and then just hit download, and then it'll start downloading. And then I'll warp and change the key from the original one. Okay, once it hits download, obviously start downloading. I'll just cancel that because I already got it. It's here. It comes in a zip format. So you just double click to unzip it. And you can delete the zip file. Double click and open. And you have this Ableton.als file in there. Now, the reason why I like Multitracks is because they actually built that set in Ableton. So we don't have to do anything, we just have to double click it and it opens in Ableton itself with all the locators and everything is just sorted. It looks like that. So you can see locators all in there. I'm just going to wait for it to buffer. If you look at the bottom left of Ableton, it sees buffering. That's fine. I'm just going to close it for now because I'll do this in a different tutorial. Now if we buy it from Loop Community, and let's just say I want to get all great things. Same thing, just do a search. With Loop Community, same thing as well. You can buy credit in advance and then you just sort of deduct the credit. The master tracks are more expensive than community tracks and obviously more expensive than premium tracks as well. So just get master, that means you get the full stem from the artist itself. So just look for it. Internet's a bit slow here. Well, once you buy it, just download it And again, it comes in a zip format. Double click on it to unzip. You can delete the zip. Double click and open. Now, the difference with Loop Community is they give you all the individual stems, but not in an Ableton setlist format. So you have to do it yourself one by one. Which is not a big deal, but it's just easier with multi-tracks. Right, see? The multi-track stems are in here. And you've got an .als file in there. But with Loop Community, it doesn't have it. They just give you the file and you just sort it out yourself. So that's loaded. You can click on Great Things. And I can see from the logo, you can get a master track, which is directly from the artist. Or if you can get it from the community tracks, which is, you know, people around the world contributing to the track. And that will be cheaper. So with the master track, you can see it's $35, which is the same price as multi-tracks. And if you click on community track, it should be cheaper as well. Cool, so those are just the two places that I usually get my tracks from. Now, if these two websites do not carry the song, chances are it's going to be very, very hard to find it elsewhere. But just Google it as you can, if you can. Alright, so that's it about buying tracks.